Thank you. Good evening, students, family, and friends. Welcome to the annual O'Gorman Christmas Vespers. We gather this evening to celebrate and anticipate Jesus' coming. During Advent, we wait for what is to come. Specifically, we wait for Jesus to come. So, during Advent, we use this time to prepare ourselves spiritually to be ready for Jesus' arrival. We prayerfully draw our minds and hearts to the second coming of Jesus at the end of time and the coming of Jesus at Christmas time. Because this is a prayer service, your participation in the responses and hymns is greatly appreciated. Tonight's service is being audio recorded. Please check to see that your phones and electronic devices are silenced. The most appropriate way to thank the service participants is with applause after the Hallelujah chorus. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Mahoney. I also want to acknowledge and thank Bishop Paul Swain for his presence and his support of the Sioux Falls Catholic Schools. Thank you also for ordaining me a priest and for sending me here. The other day, actually just today, this morning, as I was driving to school, I found that I was singing to myself a tune that we sang in Vespers when I was here in high school a little bit ago, and it just made me think of how music has that power. Music has that power to stick with us, and to fill our minds, to shape our thoughts, and to draw our hearts. And the music that we're going to hear tonight and enter into and sing along to for some of the hymns, that music has the power to draw our minds and hearts towards specifically something beautiful, which is the birth of our Lord Jesus, toward his humility, toward the love that's expressed at the creche, and to the joy that's come into the world because of the birth of our Savior. So let's take a moment just quietly and silence ourselves, silence our minds and hearts after the busyness of the day and the season. Ask the Holy Spirit to draw us, to fill us, to do with us what he wants to during this time of prayer. Let us pray. O God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation, and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the Gospel according to John. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Oh,
Reading from the Gospel according to Luke. Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor, and to gather the wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand and join us in singing O Come, O Come.
Thank you. waters, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Luke 13, verses 16 through 17. Again, this week, we are given the glorious witness of St. John the Baptist. This passage above is from year C of the liturgical cycle, but year A and B also present us with John the Baptist. In this sermon of John, he says that Jesus will come and baptize with the Holy Spirit and fire. The image of being baptized with fire is a good one to reflect upon. It especially reveals to us the deep purification Jesus desires for our souls. What does it mean to be purified? For one thing, purification of our soul hurts, but it hurts in a sweet sort of way. Turning from sin and growing closer to God requires great sacrifice and surrender, and it requires that we allow God to do powerful things within us. And the most powerful thing God wants us to do is purify us. Our Catholic faith reveals to us the reality of purgatory after we die. Purgatory is said to be a place of much spiritual pain, again, in a sweet sort of way. It's painful in the sense that we are all stripped of what we hold onto that God wants us to let go of. It's painful in the sense that we endure a complete transformation of who we are and what we love. We learn to love God and God alone, and in the embrace of our love of God, we come to love all people. It's also sweet because as we are purified, we grow infinitely closer to God and grow in holiness. This lifts the burden of sin and frees us to love as we ought. But our purification ought not start only in purgatory. We are called to enter into the process of purification here and now. We are called to heed the words of John the Baptist today and repent of all that keeps us from holiness of life. Reflect today upon the purification to which God may be called. What is it that you hold on to that he wants you free of? Commit yourself to the purifying fire of God's love and let that love cleanse you in this Advent season. Let us pray. Lord, I do long to have my soul purified by you. I do desire holiness of life. Help me to begin this process here and now so that I can begin to experience the joy and freedom you have in store for me. Jesus, I trust in you. Amen. Please stand and join us in singing Joy to the World.
Thank you. gospel according to Luke. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Please respond to the petitions with, Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for the church, that all who follow Jesus will be filled with the joy of his coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the world, that all God's children will reach out to help each other in the joy and love of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for people who suffer because of war, sickness, or lack of love, that God will send them the peace, health, and friendship they need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our grandparents, parents, pastors, and everyone looking after us in our Catholic school, that the joy and hope of Advent will fill their hearts and bring them Christ's peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for ourselves, that God will open our hearts to welcome Jesus in our neighbor, as we joyfully get ready to celebrate his birth at Christmas. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our own intentions, for all the people and needs that are in our hearts. We bring them before God, our good and loving Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join me in singing the Lord's Prayer. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
To miss an opportunity to hear our brass players. So if Mr. Koch is here, I think it's important that we still do that. Just so you know, our offertory this evening is going to one of our own, our teacher, Heather Norenberg, to support her in her new journey right now. So if we could have the brass, we'll close with that, and then any alumni at the end may be welcomed up to join us for the Hallelujah Chorus. If you want to stand next to a child, a sibling, a friend, you're sure welcome to. And we also have music on the sides of the stage, too. So, thank you.
Thank you. telling her. Hurry up, go fast. It's still late.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. the nurse.